It is great to have you back here on my CoinLady channel. What's been going on with cryptocurrency and XRP behind closed doors in Washington? We'll explain everything in this video, including secret meetings, sell-offs, and more. Watch now to find out why XRP bulls aren't rallying again. And if you enjoy the way it sounds, be sure to subscribe and like the video. There have been clandestine meetings between prominent Washington politicians and cryptocurrency barons, in case anyone was wondering. Fox News correspondent Elena Tara filled us in on a meeting that U.S. Congressman Ro Khanna convened with Democrats, White House officials, industry heavyweight Mark Cuban, and, most crucially, Ripple CEO Brad Garlinghouse. It has been speculated for some time that there will be lively debates and a plethora of behind-the-scenes activity surrounding cryptocurrency policy, particularly regulation, and the eventual outcome of decision-making. Bitcoin and Ethereum will now be handled under the commodity framework, as revealed today by the CFTC and Illinois, rather than the one that goes against them, which states that everything should be treated as a security. Also, Tennant allegedly said he would meet with cryptocurrency industry heavyweights like Mark Cuban and a few Democrats at an unregistered security event. Although the actual number of attendees is unclear, Tara revealed in this post that Ripple CEO Brad Garland and other high-ranking executives from industry heavyweights like Uniswap and Coinbase were among those in attendance. At the meeting, Kraken, Circle, and Stellar were also present. The fact that no one from the SEC or any other regulating body was there is, in my opinion, crucial to highlight here. You can find the complete list right here. There are too many for me to list them all here. While perusing them, one notices a number of significant actors in the industry, but no mention of Gary Gensler, SEC, or regulatory perspective. Reason being, the narrative surrounding cryptocurrencies is about to undergo a change. Since Gary Gensler and his associates have been left out in the cold, the truth is that everyone was hoping for a shift in the Bitcoin market, but we didn't exactly get it. We did try retesting 58,000, but in the end, we were rejected due to the relatively large sell-off in XRP and other cryptocurrencies. The current regulatory environment is dynamic. Roundtable conversations and Senate hearings with the Rothstein banner and XRP or other cryptocurrencies may not yield the desired outcomes, but they may have unforeseen market repercussions. In the midst of all this, Jerome Powell also presented the House of Representatives with his monetary policy. Both from a regulatory and, more importantly, an adoption standpoint, the past 2 days have been absolutely wild for cryptocurrencies. Why would Brad Garlinghouse be present at these events? When discussing XRP in particular, the prevailing expectation is that a lower-end fine will be announced, rather than the $2 billion the SEC won. From my vantage point, this is gaining power. Brian Armstrong of Coinbase has previously come out in favor of the shift away from XRP. This, in my opinion, also rests on that premise. However, it doesn't imply that individuals aren't anxious. This in no way implies that individuals are not tossing a coin. Regarding the potential outcomes, two large spikes in XRP transactions earlier today, as tracked by the service, showed that over 70 million XRP currencies had been moved to key crypto trading platforms, raising the issue of what was happening behind Wall Street. This occurs as the price of XRP has begun to rise again, following the recent market decline. Consequently, we saw that 33.78% of the coins and 36.52% of the XRP were sent to Bitstamp. Section heading, there are two large exchanges that occur on two bits. The Germans are currently selling off a large amount of Bitcoin, and there is ongoing discussion about the mountain. Gox incident. Listen, I think the price of XRP and the entire cryptocurrency industry is now oppressive, but that is going to change. Members of Congress, including Democrats and Republicans, and tech company CEOs, do not engage in secret meetings. The MT Gox payments aren't due until October or November, if nothing is on the way. In addition, you should not begin receiving orders for CBOE Solana ETFs and listing such ETFs. I believe the upside potential is even higher now because of the aggressive downtrend and pressure moves, and I think it's coming relatively soon. So, it's just a question of time. Look at the price of Bitcoin, it's circling the 200-day exponential moving average, which is crucial for breaking above. However, XRP is suppressed at the moment, and it has to move rather quickly to break out of this lower range. In either case, we risk seeing the support we've worked so hard to cultivate erode. After reaching a local high of roughly 74 on a daily basis, there has been a clear and persistent decline. We were informed that XRP is not a security, thus we will have to wait for that day to come. The moment is approaching. The only remaining question is when, and in my opinion, it will be very soon. All the changes happening in the White House and the narrative around them can only be good for this, in my opinion. After all, a new president could be inaugurated in November. It doesn't really faze me that I'm not American. On the other hand, you have Trump, who is pro-crypto, and Biden, who is anti-crypto. Will that be enough for XRP to ultimately be adopted by financial institutions and the cryptocurrency market as a whole to explode? You have no idea. Thank you for watching my channel and for subscribing. I'll see you later.